Kerala is often described as God's own country, but the brutal hacking of a 27-year-old Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh activist has raised serious questions about law and order and political crimes in the state. Sanjeet was hacked to death in front of his wife on a busy road in Palakkad district of Kerala. The BJP has blamed an Islamic organization, the SDPI, for the murder. Rickson Varghese gets us more.
God's own country turns red with another political killing. 27-year-old RSS worker murdered in Kerala. Tracked, surrounded and hacked to death in front of his wife in Palakkad in broad daylight. Around 9 on Monday, Sanjeet was travelling with his wife on his motorcycle. A gang of assailants in a car overtook his motorcycle, stopped him and stabbed him with sharp-edged objects as his fear-stricken wife stood shocked. She told the police she would be able to identify her husband's killers.
The
police have registered a case of murder and have initiated investigations. The BJP has blamed SDPI for the brutal killing.
Unfortunately, this is the second murder which SDPI has done within last 10 days. The CPM government is shielding the culprits.
The SDPI, on the other hand, rejected the charges.
ഇതിന്റെ അന്വേഷണത്തെ വഴിതിരിച്ചു വിടാനുള്ള വളരെ ആസൂത്രിതമായിട്ടുള്ള ശ്രമമാണ് ബിജെപിയുടെ ഭാഗത്തു നിന്ന് ഉണ്ടാകുന്നത്.
The ruling CPM has claimed that several of its workers were also murdered in Kerala.
We have more than hundreds of CPIM cadres are killed by RSS. Some RSS people are also killed. We are opposing it and we are repeatedly, Chief Minister called meeting of both the RSS and CPM together to avoid this type of killing.
A day after RSS worker in Kerala hacked to death, a delegation led by BJP state person K. Surendran met with Governor Arif Muhammad Khan and demanded a free and fair investigation into the murder case. The delegation also urged the governor to push the Kerala government to transfer the case to National Investigation Agency.
The police have recovered four sharp-edged weapons barely 4 kilometers away from the crime scene. The weapons are all blood-stained and are expected to be sent for forensic examination to match it with the blood of the victim and to look for fingerprints. With Rickson Oomen Varghese, Bureau Report, India Today.